why they call it Bay of Reckoning, because it's in the Bay Area. I get it now, Spider. That is some clever stuff. That is some clever, good stuff there.
Good job, Randy.
Thank you. Exciting. Oh, exciting bet we got coming up here, Spider. Big question mark on this one. Oli, the Oli with all the infused skaters coming out there. They made their debut yesterday with Rocky Mountain. Came out ahead, had some penalty trouble, taking on Rose City, who's been pretty consistent this year in their rotation. No one knows what to expect. This is going to be a high-impact bout, but as far as who's coming out again, it's anyone's guess.
Right, and Oli had a sort of what's considered maybe a lighter season, and their biggest games actually coming at the end of the season against Minnesota and Texas. They played Sac City and Dockyard Derby Dames earlier in the season and got some of those games under their belt. And so now we're here to see what Oli can bring to the table.
It's the big unknown. They've been the big question mark all season long, and especially with this roster right now. It's going to be contentious. We're going to start off right now. That's White Flight on the jammer line for the Rose City Rollers in purple.
And 0-3 Adamatrix for the Oli Rollers, and she takes the initial lead, and she takes on Mercy at the front of that pack.
With J.K. Rowland and Scratcher, Scrappy Golucky, sorry, and that's a lead jam for Adamatrix.
We have White Flight now going through on the inside line. Psycho Babble trying to get out in front of her to take control.
Jumps to the inside, their initial pass for White Flight.
Adamatrix now going through on her scoring pass. She's going to get a back block major. This is now a power jam for White Flight.
She engaged Blast Unicorn in her first scoring pass. So she's probably picked up a few points, though, but it's a power jam for White Flight in the Wheels of Justice.
Oh, huge hit on Joy Collision by J.K. Rowling.
Wow. Now they've got the trap trying to slow it down, but great defense up front for Oli there, Spider.
Yeah, Hockey Honey doing a nice job on the inside line. Working together with Joy Collision now at the front.
Looks like Blast Unicorn trying to go a little bit of offense. And White Flight tried to call off the jam, but she is not lead jammer. I thought she was called it earlier, but I might be totally making that up in my head. I might just be... No, because Adam was out first.
That's right.
Yeah, okay.
Mercy, the Blast Unicorn, holding the back line there. White Flight looking for an opportunity for an assist there. Psycho Babble, Joy Collision, Scared to Death with the three wall in the front there.
This has been Wheels of Justice's biggest opportunity all season long, is tactical coordinated offense. And this is a situation right now. And a cut major. She got hit. White Flight was hit to the inside.
Yeah, at the back of the pack, what was happening is they were engaging Hockey Honey and trapped her, knocked her to the infield. She skirted around the back, and at the same time, White Flight got that major cut.
Absolutely. So Adamatrix is out, and that's her first scoring pass. All 5 points. She gets the point for White Flight, and that is time, Spider.
So first jam of the evening. Oli on the scoreboard with 5. Rose City also on the scoreboard with 5.
First jam of the evening, 2 Bauer jams.
That's right.
How can you have 2 power jams in 1 jam?
Well, it just happened.
That's craziness. I'd like to thank Rydell, the official skate of the WFDDA. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance. Like both these teams, RydellSkates.com.
We're going to have Onda Sly at the line in a power jam for the Oli Rollers. Lil Tonka holding the outside lane, trying to make some room. However, Havana Good Time knocks her out of bounds. Onda Sly going right through the center of the pack, pick up lead jammer status for the Oli Rollers.
Mel Mangles got a false start, so she had to cycle around the track to get into a legal position there.
Again, I know I talked about it yesterday, but Onda Sly transfer from Slaughter County Roller Vixens, a team in Kitsap County, Washington. Oh, Onda Sly with a grand slam. That's 10 points on the scoreboard for Oli.
Oli trapping Heidi Goes Seek there. They have her and breaking up that wall. French Tickler with a big hit on Onda Sly in the inside. Cycles to the back of the pack, but
Onda Sly now pulls through for another grand slam. And, you know, she's employing a lot of those hockey skills, as you can see her go around the track. Oh!
Quick work of that wall. Just falls apart there. Another 5 points.
Yeah, nice little pirouette at the end as she gets knocked around a bit. Doesn't lose her balance. Does a little spin. White Flight getting knocked out on the straightaway.
Echo hitting and cycling White Flight to the back. And this is still White Flight's initial pass.
Echo, Lil Tonka. Lil Tonka with a hit on Mel Mangles on the straightaway. On the slide, going to try to get around Heidi Go Seek and French Tickler.
Initial pass there for Wyatt Flight. No points yet. On the slide, still on another scoring pass.
On the slide, making the decision just to call off a jam as she chooses not to get around Havana Good Time. But that's four more points on the board.
19 points there for On the slide in that jam.
We're now sitting at 5 points for Rose City, 24 points for Ole with 25 minutes and 47 seconds left on the first period clock.
And the only penalties so far are jammers.
Oh, and Sassy, the pivot, is now sitting in the penalty box.
Oh. Missed that call, I'm afraid.
We're going to have Lindsay Loblo, number 52, jamming for Ole, going up against Sulfuric Acid, number 20 for Rose City.
Sulfuric Acid navigating that back wall of Ole there. Around the outside, lead jammer, Sulfuric Acid.
Mercy staying out in front of Hockey Honey. Now Psychobabble going to take on Mercy. Mercy now recycling out in front of Lindsay Loblo to join Kit Cassidy and Frank Inherter.
Joy Collision tried to pick off J.K. Rowling, but picked up a penalty for her effort. And Sulfuric Acid with 5 points, a quote-unquote natural grand slam, as Ole's jammer is still in play.
Lindsay Loblo now trying to get around Mercy, looking for an avenue there. Psychobabble now recycling back. Doesn't connect with Sulfuric Acid. Sulfuric Acid is going to pull through for another grand slam. That's going to bring Rose City to 15 points, Ole at 24.
10 points already for still over a minute in this jam for Sulfuric Acid, and no initial pass for Lindsay Loblo yet. She goes into a defensive jamming position.
And there goes Psychobabble trying to get out there with Hockey Honey. Lindsay struggling to get around and forced out by Mercy.
All right, pushes 20 feet there. Sulfuric Acid with another 5 points. It's going to bring its score to 20-24. And if she can get them one more grand slam, that will be a lead change in Rose City's favor.
Huge, powerful jam for Sulfuric Acid. Defensive jamming there on Lindsay as she knocks her out.
Great offensive screen there by J.K. Rowling, giving a huge pass there for 5 points. That is the lead change. And Sulfuric Acid picking up 20 points already on this jam.
Oh, and Mercy recycling to the front to stay out in front of Lindsay. Lindsay tries to juke to the left to get around Mercy. Mercy able to maintain that positional block in front of her. Psycho gets up to try to get her out of the way.
Sulfuric Acid with a patient approach to the pack there. Mercy hitting Lindsay Loblo to the inside and cycling to the back. Lindsay Loblo still on her initial pass. That's going to be the jam call for time. Three more points picked up by Sulfuric Acid. 23-point jam, a 4-point lead for Rose City. Well, this is an exciting start, Spider.
Not to be outdone, these two teams have faced off four times previously, Ole taking the win, but Rose City coming within just mere points.
Sulfuric Acid blowing love to all her fans. Tired of sliding through slippery corners? Try the new Radar Villain Wheel.
First time at the line for this bout is Scald Eagle, a crowd favorite, number 50, head up against Adamatrix 03.
It takes a outside run there, but gets clipped off by Sassy. Does get to the inside and is going to try to eat the baby. That's when a jammer stuffs another jammer back into the pack. But, you know, racing Adamatrix is a dangerous gamble. Looks like, trying to kill a little time off the penalty clock for Mel Mangles there. Scald Eagle calls off the jam.
Wise decision there. It's not an easy task to take on Adamatrix given just the nature of her speed.
She pretty good, as we say where I come from.
As we say in Washington?
Yeah, Washington, Oregon.
Pacific Northwest.
White Flight back up the line. That's a 4-3 blocker advantage for Ole, which is a dangerous advantage for Ole.
On to slide 66, going to try to get around French Tickler on the inside. She goes then to turn to go to the outside line. She gets hung up in the front of the pack by Frenchie and Scrappy. She gets through to pick up lead jammer status.
Yep. Ole are very dangerous with the blocker advantage. White Flight still navigating her initial pass. Big hit from Joy Collision on Scrappy Go Lucky to the inside, Spider.
On the slide, pulling around Scrappy Go Lucky. She's going to pull through for the 4 points. She got a no pass, no penalty.
pass out of play, so that will bring her to only 4 points. But wow, that was a fancy skate around there. White Flight still on her initial pass.
A little bit of a spill at the back of the pack for Onda Sly. The score is now tied at 28-28. Onda Sly now trying to go to the outside as White Flight puts on that defensive cap.
All right, it looks like Vanna Goodtime went to the penalty box, taking place of Mel Mangles there. Oh, no, that's fancy.
Onda Sly still trying to get around Mel Mangles.
Mel Mangles, Echo going in for some offense there. Love exchange. That's 4 more points. Holy's going to take back the lead, courtesy of Onda Sly.
Rose City sitting at 28, only sitting at 32, 20 minutes, 42 seconds left on the first period clock.
That is Animatrix on the jammer line of Adam Wheels, a proud partner and official wheel of WFDA.
Sulfuric Acid, number 20, now jamming for Rose City Rollers. Pack right, advantage so for Ole.
Right off the bat, Rose City cannot afford this. They only have 2 blockers in the pack right now. This is such a this is where Ole does their best work, is in the pack, and they capitalize on an advantage big time. Rose City cannot afford to be sending the blockers to the box like this.
And Adamatrix going to try to get around Mercy.
The jammer called for Adamatrix. Saw that coming in. Sulfuric Acid with a major back block there. This is the second power jam for Ole Rollers, and we can expect a lot of points to be put on the board for Ole right now.
Yes, as Adamatrix goes in, again, 2 blockers on the track for Rose City. Mercy taking a spill, Adamatrix jumping over her for the full 5 points. That's going to bring Ole to 42, Rose City 28.
Frank and Herter returning to the back to assist there.
Sassy, Lil Tonka, Chikachula, and Scara to death now trapping Frankenherter at the back pack. She makes her way through with an assist by Havana Good Time, but another grand slam fielded and put on the scoreboard for Adamatrix.
All right. Well, Frankenherter gets up to the front of the pack there to put themselves in a defensive position. Nice bridging going on there. And Adam goes ahead and calls it off. They decide to ice the jammer. 5 more points for Ole. Ole running away 52-28. I'd like to thank Gern Munster. Gern Munster, Dirk Gern. Makers of Antic Gumball Toast Tops, Hard Loose Wheels, Reckless Wheels, and Motor Bearings. Gern Munster doesn't just give you great Verbally Derby products, they give you confidence. They do not give you vowels. GRNMNSTR.com. They tried to register .cm, but it doesn't exist.
Psychobabble now in on a power jam. The earlier bout yesterday, Psychobabble wasn't used as a jammer until the second half. So interesting they're throwing her in here so soon in the first half.
Heck, why not? You got a power jam, and she can skate fancy, so might as well capitalize.
Layla Lawdown now headed to the penalty box for Ole. Psychobabble makes it to take lead jammer status. Echo with nice recycling to get out in front of J.K. Rowling.
All right, and that is Joy Collision going to the penalty box for a major multiplayer block. Initial pass made by Sulfuric Acid and Rose City with a blocker advantage, 4-2.
Yeah, as they race the pack out in front, Echo Hockey Honey sitting or skating right in front of Psychobabble. Psychobabble going to try to go through Heidi Go Seek and J.K. Rowling.
She picked up 2 points there, 0 for Sulfuric Acid. 28-54, but now the blocker advantage belongs to Rose City.
We want to thank Iron Doll Clothing. They have custom uniforms for the modern roller girl and the referee, lifting and separating since 2009.
They sure do. And there are fans everywhere. They're thankful. 4-2 blocker advantage, and that is Scald Eagle. And a team timeout called for Olympia. Oh, the Rollers there, that's their first of 3.
Yeah, we have 17 minutes and 11 seconds left on the first period clock. Ole sitting at 54 points, Rose City with 28. Ole able to really take advantage of those power jams and rack up some points there. Rose City in their power jam also taking advantage. Rotating power jams.
So far, Ole is 5 minutes in the penalty box. Rose with 4 minutes. These are unofficial stats, so we're getting them as they're updated. But pretty tight so far, but it's those power jams where Ole are going to run away with it. They're going to do it each and every time. So the discipline has to be maintained by Rose City to stay on the track. They can't give up a blocker advantage, and they got to get their jammers out there.
Check out the bracket bonanza sponsor, 2-in-1 Skate Shop. Take 10% off your entire order.
Yeah, in a 4-2, you're going to put two blockers out there. You may get sassy in Psycho Battle.
Yeah, sassy earning the MVP award for best blocker at a championship in previous seasons.
I'm sorry, that's a 3-2 blocker advantage for Rose City.
And they switched it out only as they sent in Adamatrix as opposed to Scare to Death. Adamatrix now taking on French Tickler. French Tickler trying to knock it to the infield.
Looks like Skull Eagle trying to push 20 feet against Sassy, and Sassy cycles her to the inside. Adamatrix has to get past French Tickler and White Flight there.
Skull Eagle with easy run on the inside lane as she makes her way around Psycho Babble for the lead jammer position, and the crowd just erupts.
Adamatrix finally dukes around the outside. French Tickler gets her initial pass.
And now Sassy and Psycho Babble moving to the front of the pack to perhaps protect those points.
Layla Law down, gets in there, and 3 points picked up, some penalty box points there for Scald Eagle, bringing it to 31 to Oldie's 54. We're still a 23-point lead for Rose City.
If you enjoy the unusual, Derbyology.com, they are purveyors of the Derby unusual. They're not crazy, they just like Derby. Mm-hmm. Derbyology.com.
Mm-hmm.
What is not unusual is now we're going to see sulfuric acid jamming for Rose City Rollers.
On the slide, jamming for Ole with a blocker advantage of 4-2-3. And Mel Mangles sending on the slide to the back. On the slide, Mel Mangles. They have a lot. Oh, wow! Great dance around the inside there, but Mercy cycles on the slide to the back. So on slide is lead jammer, but still on her initial pass.
Hockey Honey now taking her first trip to the penalty box.
Sulfuric Acid is trying to navigate past Joy Collision and Echo. So that's her initial pass. Now she's not lead, so we're going to probably see 0-0 and Echo go to the penalty box for an out of play.
All right, so
fans definitely on Rose City's side here. I wonder why!
I have no idea.
Hockey Honey picked up her fourth minor there on her way to the penalty box there. Look at that hit now. Jumpsuit, beautiful. It's just the hammer and nail setup for Mercy. That was, everyone played that, played well. That was amazing.
Psycho Babble jamming for Ole and Scald Eagle. Last Unicorn goes on the inside to try to stave off Psycho Babble gonna stay on one skate. She's gonna not pick up lead jammer status. She got a forearm minor.
We got a 4-2 blocker advantage for Rose City, and Rose City is finally slowing it down to give Scald lead jammer. Scald checks in wisely, may I add, to her bench. They get her to call it off. That's 0-0, and we're starting with a 4-2 blocker advantage for Rose City. I'm shocked. I'm shocked at the jammer selection right now, Spider.
I imagine you are, as am I.
Mind-blowing.
Adamatrix and sulfuric acid.
That's crazy. What are these teams thinking?
I see Scare to Death.
I see Scare to Death.
And Joy Collision.
Alrighty. We're going to have a volume adjustment right now, as we were told to put the mics closer to our mouth. Oh, big fall there by Adamatrix, but she's up again. And that is sulfuric acid. Initial pass, not lead jammer. Adamatrix is lead jammer. Calls the jam. Still 4-2 blocker advantage.
Interesting.
Still 23-point lead for Ole.
They are going to switch it up a little bit and send in Onda Sly to take on Scald Eagle. Joy Collision and Scare to Death remain the blockers from the previous jam. Oh.
Hey, there's nope. Rob Lobster talking to refs about stuff.
That's an important thing to do occasionally.
Well, it's so important he does it a lot. 4-2 blocker advantage. Skull Eagle quickly on the inside. Lead jammer. And is that only one? Yeah, there is only one blocker out there.
Joy Collision. Hockey Honey, though, going to come in and join as a reinforcement onto Slag, and it's pushed out on the straightaway before turn three.
That was a very good time with that defensive hit. Oh, shrugs off a hit on the inside. 5 points there for Scald Eagle.
Yeah, there just wasn't any opposition, and we have Onda Sly now headed to the penalty box.
All of the penalties are being picked up by Oli right now.
Oh, no, that's not Onda Sly, pardon me. That was Joy Collision. So Onda Sly working around, getting around Havana good time. She gets knocked out on the straightaway, and Scald Eagle.
Havana good time picks up an out-of-play call. She was able to cycle Onda Sly back into the pack. It's going to be... I'm going to see if that penalty was worth it as they have to let Onda Sly go. Another out of play by Frankenherter. This is not going to help Rose City's situation. In a 2-2, Oli are going to have the advantage. That's just physics.
There's Echo, Hot Honey, and Scared to Death now in the pack, but Scald Eagle pulling around, and she does get four more points. We're going to bring this to a 10-point difference. Oh, 45-54 in favor. Oh. In favor of Oli.
I gotta say, while that is a great run by Rose City, it is not worth taking those penalties for Rose City. They're gonna be way better off capitalizing with their players on the track. The score, you know, even though it might have an immediate impact on what's happening, the long term of Oli having a blocker advantage or a 2-2, it will result in a negative deficit. Sulfuric acid on the line for Rose City.
With Adamatrix for the Oli Rollers.
I rest my case. Adamatrix, lead jammer.
She does pull around Psychobabble, working with Sassy. Psychobabble with an assist out of bounds on Sulfuric Acid. Lil Tonka and Psychobabble and Sassy now hanging out at the back of the pack. Adamatrix going to try to get around JK Rowling.
All right. It looks like Sulfuric Acid gets her initial pass. Points are already going to be picked up by Adamatrix. That is all five.
Adamatrix looks to the bench. They tell her to call it off. She picks up another 5 points to put on the scoreboard for Oli, bringing them to 59. Rose City sitting at 45. 10 minutes, 42 seconds left on the first period clock.
Bones Bearings at bonesbearings.com. Roller Bones and Bones Bearings. Ollie's a winning combination.
So we're going to have Scared to Death jamming for the Oli Rollers.
And Untamed True. Adamatrix sitting on 30 points right now. On the slide, 27. Sulfuric Acid, 23. And Scald Eagle, 17. These are top scorers so far in this bout.
Lindsay Blowblow and Hockey Honey working on the outside. And a huge little tumble there at the back of the pack for Untamed True. Again, Untamed True, first time at the jammer line. And we have a low block major on Lindsay Blowblow as she heads to the penalty box. Oh, and a high block major for Scared to Death. So now this is a power jam in favor of Untamed True.
Hockey Honey and Echo doing some damage on Untamed True. Untamed True does make her initial pass, though, and is the jammer.
Echo now working at the back of the pack for Oli with Hockey Honey.
Already engaging, trying to get some offense.
Joy Collision trying to move with a nice little escort to the infield on Untamed True.
Inside lane wide open, but Hockey Honey gets in there. She goes ahead and called it for four more points, bringing it to 50-59. And we're going to start this next jam in the power jam, Spider.
Psychobabble now taking a leisurely sit on the jammer line.
So far, Oli with 11 minutes in the penalty box and Rose with only seven. Now, a couple of Roses were jammers, but Oli clearly doing good with the execution. Even though they have the more minutes in the penalty box, they still have the lead with 9 points.
That's true. They have actually had, I think, at least two jammers. The first jam with Adamatrix and now Scared to Death sitting in the penalty box at minimum. Scald Eagle jump on the apex there, and she picks up lead jammer status for Rose City.
Blast Unicorn, it looks like. Blast Unicorn trying to slow down the pack by picking off Psychobabble and or Sassy. Bold. I like it, but they are successful to get a trap and actually slow down the pack.
Nice little sternum check there by Mercy on Psychobabble. Psychobabble skirts around JK Rowling on the outside to recycle to join Sassy in the front of the pack. Lil Tonka now the choice, and she does a nice job of evading JK Rowling and the Blast Unicorn.
Sassy last line of defense there. She's getting some assistance from Psychobabble now. Scald already has these points, and Scared to Death does make her initial pass. She's probably going to end pretty soon. It looks like she's killing a little bit of time to release her blocker from the penalty box. Worth it. That's going to be 5 points. We have a four-point bout here, Spider.
If you like everything roller derby, check out Blood and Thunder. Blood and Thunder is the world's first and largest roller derby magazine. Find them at bloodandthundermag.com.
We will.
I already have.
4-3 blocker advantage for Oli. On to Sly out there jamming as well. Sulfuric acid. This is going to be good.
What an amazing showing. 4 points now separating these teams. Rose City at 55, Oli at 59. Joy Collision moved to the front of the pack.
On to Sly, hit to the outside, but she was lead jammer before she got out there, cycled to the back. We have a lead jammer, but both jammers are still in their initial pass.
Now on to Sly, going to try to make her way around French Tickler and Scrappy Go Lucky. Nice little jump there.
French Tickler has to let her go as her 20 feet out. Lead jam on the Sly, out on her, sitting up for her first scoring pass.
On to Sly, looking to go on the outside. She runs again into Scrappy Go Lucky and French Tickler at the front.
It looks like Kick Cassidy with a major back block there going to the penalty box. Not good for Rose City there. Hockey Honey picked up a penalty as well. I missed that one, Spider.
As did I. She heads to the penalty box. We now have Sulfuric Acid pulling back. We have a grand slam now for Oli Rollers on to Sly, increasing their point advantage 64-55, Rose City. Echo.
Cut major on Echo there. That's going to be the initial pass for Sulfuric Acid. And Mel Mangles back into the penalty box. I believe that's going to be her third. That is not a good position. She is a very high execution player, and she needs to be on the track. If we're sounding tense, it's because we are tense. This is a tense bout. All righty, a little jammer handoff there. That is Gold Eagle up at the jammer line. And Animatrix, the jam has started. Make no mistake. Oli killing time there. 2-2. It looks like Blast Unicorn was removed from the track because the whistle started with her having her pivot cap on. Lead jammer has been assessed to Scald Eagle. She's been cycled back in.
Adamatrix.
Adamatrix is her initial pass.
Adamatrix is the lead jammer.
Oh, it's the lead jammer. Sorry about that. That was a photo finish there. That was a hard fight back, but only Sassy is the only blocker for Oli on the track. Initial pass made by Scald Eagle.
That's right, a scare to death now going to the penalty box. Mercy going to the penalty box. Adamatrix is going to pull around Hockey Honey and Sassy still on the track. Kick Cassidy.
You're going to the penalty box. You're going to the penalty box. Everybody check under their penalty box seats. You all win a prize. You're all going to the penalty box. All right.
Because we all have penalty boxes at home.
It's called your couch. That jam is called before Scald Eagle can hit it. 0-0 on that last pass. Oli 68, Rose City 55. A 13-point bout. 4 minutes and a half seconds. Untamed Shrew up in the line. This is bananas. The crowd's going wild. Everyone's losing their minds out here.
Including you.
Clearly. I'm going to the penalty box now.
You might get a better viewpoint from there, but I doubt it. Untamed Shoe number 21, jamming for Rose City Rollers, and Adamatrix 03 for Oli. Hockey Honey, Chica Chula, and Lil Tonka making up the pack for Oli. Blast Unicorn, Scrappy Go Lucky, and Mercy in the pack for Rose City.
All right, both jammers engage. Looks like Hockey Honey cycles Untamed Shoe to the back of the back there.
Adamatrix pulls through, takes lead jammer status for the Oli Rollers.
Hockey Honey, a thorn and Untamed Shrew side, cycles out, gets her to the inside.
Oh, got nice. Nice move by Mercy. And we're going to get a major forearm for Hockey Honey. She heads back to the penalty box. Per my count, that's three times to the penalty box.
I believe that was the hit to the inside that she executed there. And that is the initial pass there for Untamed Shrew. To stop this bleeding here for Adamatrix, that is going to be how many points? 3-point error.
It appears that Adamatrix may have had some technical difficulty with her skate that forced her to call off the jam there.
It couldn't have been her wheels.
No, it was the top of her skate.
That wouldn't look good at all. All right, still 2-2 in the pack. We got penalties, all the penalties, 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 penalties. I'm telling you, ladies and gentlemen, if you're watching this and you want to look at what can improve your team's chances in about practice staying on the track, goes a long way. Sulfuric acid on the line for Rose City.
And on to Sly. Oh, sulfuric acid on the inside as she makes her way around Sassy. Sassy with a huge hit on having a good time.
Everybody, 3-2 blocker advantage. Rose City trying to slow down the pack to give sulfuric acid a scoring opportunity here.
Sassy and Joy Collision out the front of the pack, trying to protect those points.
Doing a good job of it, may I add. Sulfuric acid goes ahead and called it. That's going to be a 0-0.
Yes, as on the slide pulls very closely to the back of the pack. Sulfuric acid not going to take that.
I know what you're thinking at home. You're thinking you got some printing to do. You have printing needs. You need to do something about printing. Well, I've got some good news for you. Printcographics.com for your league's printing and promotional needs. Hit up printcographics.com. See? We take care of you here. WFTA.TV.
1 minute, 35 seconds left on the period clock. Woolley 71, Rose City 55. Adamatrix struggling to get back past the 3-watt. The back, Scald Eagle is your lead jammer. Chica Chula and Adamatrix going to the box. This is a power jam for Scald Eagle.
A blocking out of play, apparently. So what that means for Adamatrix is she engaged when that no pack was happening. That is, you can get it as a jammer too. White flag going to the penalty box. 5 points for Scald Eagle.
11.
Bring it to 60-71.
An 11-point difference. Very little time left on the period clock. Hockey Honey, Lil Tonka working at the front of the pack. Mercy and French E taking on Psychobabble, trying to hold her back.
That's not easy. And Hockey Honey cycles Scald Eagle to the back of the pack there. Scald Eagle on a scoring pass here. It's just over a minute to try to get 3 scoring passes to take the lead back in this first period. But Ole's got that good defense, you know. They ain't going to make it easy.
And there she goes, right on the inside lane, 5 points. And I'm sure Rose City says, welcome back, Scald Eagle. Frenchie going to the penalty box.
The penalty box says, welcome, Rose City skater.
It put out a welcome mat just for them. Oh, Adamatrix now back in the action. She makes easy use of the inside lane as there was no opposition there.
All right, go ahead and call that with the inside. That's gonna be how many more points? 4 more points at the half. Oh, Spider, we have a 2-point bout going into the second period. 71 only. Rose City 69. That's as good as about gets. Remember, this is to guarantee a spot to champions. The winner will play in the 1-2 bout tomorrow. Whoever does not win still has a chance to fight for third, but if you win this, you're going. It's happening. It's done.
It's kind of a big deal. That's all I'm saying. Wheels of Justice cheers all around. Skaters leading that cheer with the fans in the crowd. Wheels of Justice with a powerful run here, 69-71. Ole also running into some penalty trouble themselves.
Well, the penalties seem to be pretty even right now, but the thing with the penalties with these two teams are Ole can capitalize. They have a stronger one-on-one game. They have a stronger 2-on-2 game. They can capitalize on an individual level. Rose City are way better off with a pack teamwork dynamic. They need to have their walls set up. They need everybody in there. So even though the penalties are relatively even, Ole's going to come out ahead. You know, with Ole, you want to take them on. You want to have far less minutes in the penalty box than they do. And that's got to be Rose City's focus going into the second period. Execution, they are great, but they need the penalty numbers in their advantage for this. As far as Ole goes, they got to stay on the track too. I mean, a different dynamic of execution. But that's what it's going to come down to. If Ole can keep it even, they have a great shot of taking over. Rose City, they need to be way ahead on penalty minutes.
I agree. And really, historically, again, Rose City taking four losses to Ole. However, they've all been very, very, very close and very, very tight. And this has been an issue in all of those games with penalties and I think a lot of emotionality. There seems to be kind of a rivalry here, suspect.
There is not good blood between them, and it hasn't improved over the years, and that's just a reality. So that gets the emotions going for both teams and works against both teams, you know.
I absolutely agree, and I see it every time I watch them skate against one another. And both phenomenal teams and both really earning their spots here. But
that emotion tends to work against Rose City more than Ole. Ole's ready for it. They get a lot of people, you know, they don't have people cheering for them except for at home. But Rose City, when it gets to them, it brings them to a disadvantage. So now they have a huge crowd cheering for them. That might make a huge difference here. The second period, we'll see. It's going to be tight.
Yeah. Check in to WFTDA.tv.
And now some words from our sponsors. If you're just tuning in right now, ladies and gentlemen, you're crazy. You missed a great first period of this Rose City Ole 4-seed, 1-seed bout to go on to play the championship bout. We have a 2-point bout right now. Penalties going back and forth like crazy. High execution derby being played. Oh, my goodness. It is exciting. I think we're going to have an exciting second period.
Oh, the first period. Fantastic. Fantastic to watch. Fantastic for fans. You could just hear the entire crowd just erupt as Wheels of Justice pulled back up to Ole. And Ole not pulling so far ahead. I mean, it's certainly Rose City just bringing it to the table. Ole with that counterplay and really nice defense for Ole. And both teams putting up some pretty hefty penalty minutes.
Well, both teams are very high execution teams. Now, Rose City going into this, their biggest opportunity from the first period is they got to be careful what the out-of-play calls. They have pulled so many when Ole's in a power jam and racing away. Rose is spreading themselves out so thin. They are consistently getting one out-of-play after another, and you do not want to give a penalty advantage or even go even on penalties with Ole because Ole is one of the highest execution teams in the game ever. So it's got to be about communication and patience from Rose City if they want to take this.
And we discussed right as we were going out of the first period that the high level of emotion comes into play. I know that all of you at home can't be here, but the energy is really intense in here. And there's some definitively higher fan base for one side, if you might imagine.
That's crazy talk. And why would that be?
And so this happens, and the environment is super electric, super charged, and a 2-point game. Oh, amazing. Amazing for fans. Amazing for me. It's super fun.
Now, Ole get really hot. But it's with each other. They don't really get affected by the fans. They're used to people not cheering for them over the last couple of years. But it's the relationship with each other. And with a lot of skaters that haven't worked together enough, their big challenge for the second period is to relax and get comfortable with each other. Rose City have the opportunity to use the fans to their advantage. Now, it's not going to be a disadvantage to Ole. They're ready for it. They're ready for the head game. They don't need people cheering for them. They just need to trust each other and get used to each other. Rose City needs to try to capitalize on the fans to give them the support and the patience to execute. Because if they don't play with patience, Ole's running away with this.
Well, they're certainly not rolling away with it at the moment.
Nope. Certainly not. But the second period tends to favor Ole. Traditionally, throughout the years, the second period favors Ole. So
And so we are going to start this out. We have sulfuric acid taking on Atomatrix.
Alrighty.
Hockey Honey and Intended Anger. We haven't seen Intended Anger in the pack thus far with Joy Collision. All taking a knee, forcing the immediate second whistle, trying to create some room on the outside line for Atomatrix. And it works. There she goes. It's Atomatrix taking lead jammer status. Oh, nice takedown. White Flight by Hockey Honey. Hockey Honey now recycling to the front of the pack.
White Flight doing a lot more time as a blocker here. I think she, like, according to my set, she's sitting on three minors, so that might have a lot to do with it. Animatrix already on a scoring pass.
Animatrix. Oh, JK Rowling with just a beautiful, she tries to escort her out at turn four. Does it keep her as Animatrix just slips around her?
Animatrix, give a millimeter, take a scoring pass. She can always get around as long as there's any room to edge through. She does. Calls off with 5 points as Sulfuric Acid gets out of the pack.
Yeah, she has amazing awareness of exactly where her skates are on the track, and she can just come within, I mean, she's right on it and still manage to stay in bounds.
So it looks like Rose City is sitting on three blockers now with one more in the queue to come out of the penalty box. And only with, it looks like, two blockers if mine eyes aren't deceiving me.
Yep, that's Sassy and Scared to Death.
Psych, there's one less there as Scrappy was pulled. I guess, yes, there is another. Yeah, White Flight is still in the penalty box. Maybe she picked up her fourth minor.
And we have Mercy working the outside. Scared to Death now going to try to make a play here to get around Mercy. Oh, nice hit by Frenchie on to Sly.
There's a Scald Eagle trying to push Sassy. Scared to Death with the bridge there. Sassy, not an easy blocker to push out 20 feet. In fact, probably the least easy. Scared to Death going in to hammer and nail her in the front.
And we have a multiple player block.
That is Frankenherder.
Frankenherder. On to Sly. She's going to get a nice little whip there at the end. She picks up lead jammer status for the Oli Rollers.
That's after 45 seconds, but there you have it. Blocker advantage for Oli. They are going to capitalize. Looks like Chikachula?
Yeah, that is Chikachula. Yeah. She's a pivot for the Oli Rollers. Sassy puts up her arms onto Sly. Skirts around the right-hand side. Chikachula Scared to Death now working the front of the pack with Sassy. Joy Collision now back in the action. She's going to try to fly past Mercy. Gets some assist by Scared to Death. Oh, Mercy and Joy Collision go out at turn one.
Another huge scoring pass there by on the Sly there. Five more points. Scald Eagle still on her initial pass and a blocker advantage for Oli. This is when Oli is at their most dangerous. They will pull the score away every time they have an advantage. You're seeing it right now.
And here goes Anda Sly. She's going to make her way around. She's going to put 5 points on the scoreboard for the Oli Rollers. They're getting awfully close to the century mark. And they're sitting at 96. Rose City, 69.
DerbySkins.com, the original shiny hiney. Maybe imitated, never duplicated. Derby Skins.
As we go into this jam, Psychobabble, pardon me, is going to try to pick up that intentional fourth, get it out of the way. Animatrix donning the star for the Oli Rollers, and Sulfuric Acid donning the star for the Wheels of Justice.
3-3 in the pack there, so even odds as far as numbers, but Rose City have a harder time capitalized, but lead jammer does go to Sulfuric Acid.
Animatrix pushes her way through. She makes her way out of the pack.
Another multiplayer block picked up by Rose City skaters, so they've replaced blocking out of play with multiplayers right now. Again, those penalties, not worth it. Quick hit and quit, 0-0 jam there for Rose City.
We have a palindrome score.
I like palindromes. You know what else I like?
You like Fast Girl Skates, the first full-service brick-and-mortar derby store in the world, brings extensive in-store experience to you online. We know firsthand how to make happy and skater, feet happy and skaters fast. www.fastgirlskates.com. That's what you like?
It is. It's like you read my mind, Randy Pan.
It was a guess.
I know. A lucky one. White Flight and on to Slide.
3-2 blocker advantage for Oli. And nonetheless, White Flight.
Illegal procedures.
That had to have been a false start. And a fourth minor by Onda Sly. I believe that was a fourth minor illegal procedure. Neither jammer was released. They both skated off. A White Flight did not yield, so she got the major. On to Sly, because there was no one to yield to, picked up the minor, but that was her fourth, so all we got here is a two-minute jam.
Oh, Mercy just knocking out Chikachula on the straightaway. White Flight now trying to pull around Sassy. Sassy, the pivot for the Oli Rollers.
Rose City allowing the pack to go pretty darn fast.
Yeah, and Oli, known for its speed, Onda Sly is through. Again, we will not have a lead jammer as both jammers started out. Well, didn't start out there, but they ended up in the penalty box.
That is their initial pass. My Stars and Garters, we have all 10 skaters on the track right now. This is going to be necessary for Rose City, but Oli still favoring the lead right now.
Oh, huge hit on Psycho Babble. I'm sorry.
From Mel Mingles there.
That wasn't Psycho Babble. It was actually Scared to Death. My apologies.
All defense from both teams. Mercy trying to mix it up with Chikachula and Sassy to give White Flight a scoring pass. She does it. I'm sorry. I apologize. That is her initial pass. No points yet there. Fourth minor, I believe, picked up for Mel Mangles.
We have Onda Sly through for four more points on the scoreboard.
So this is going to be a points race. If White Flight can get through here, she can even it up.
Oh, nice threading there by J.K. Rowling as Psycho Babble tries to go in for a hit. White Flight now headed to the penalty box? No.
I guess they took it. That was a 3-3 on that one, so that jam is going to favor Oli as they come out 4 points ahead. 31-point lead for the Oli Rollers right now. And a 4-2 blocker advantage for Oli.
Animatrix and Untamed Shrew. This is the second time we've seen Untamed Shrew.
Team timeout for Rose City.
Wheels of Justice. Check out Derbalife.com. Roller derby nutrition at its finest. I'm sure many of the skaters on the track currently participating and have checked out Derbalife.com.
While you're in this team timeout, you can check out, you can try playing Jammer Up, jammerup.com, the first strategy board game based on modern day roller derby.
And if you don't have it at home, now you can buy it.
The two things I'm nerdiest about in life coming together. It doesn't look like an official review, but Rob Lobster is talking to Mr. Rock about stuff.
You know, you're watching Mercy and Scald Eagle out on the track. They're doing left turn training. The coaching done by Mercy, Scald Eagle, and Jukebox that'll help make your skaters more awesome than they already think they are.
And they might be wearing Wicked Skatewear. In the meantime, their hearts their sponsor leagues, Denver, Bay Area, Angel, Arizona, and Angel City there. All right, so right now Olympia, 15 minutes in the penalty box. So I think they had about 6 power jams so far. Rose City, 13 minutes in the penalty box. But only 3 power jams so far, so power jams heavily favoring Oli right now. And even though the penalties have relatively even, Oli's are more spread out. Lead jammer, Animatrix.
Animatrix makes her way through. Scald Eagle still trying to get through the pack. Echo working at the front of the pack with Joy Collision. Hockey Honey now pushes Scald Eagle, doesn't quite get the hit she intends, and Scald Eagle doesn't go to the infield. Push from Kit Cassidy there on Scald Eagle.
It's initial pass there for Skull Eagle. 5 point scoring pass picked up by Animatrix calls it.
Oli really going to the second half and taking that momentum as they push their score to 108. Rose City sitting at 72 with 22 minutes, 23 seconds left on the period clock.
Rob Lobster having an issue with the hit. I believe it was the... He saw Animatrix, there was no call made on it, but I saw a gesture that reflected that.
Psycho Babble and Untamed Shrew.
3-2 blocker advantage for Oli. Rose City just having a really hard time staying out of the penalty box.
Oh, Psycho Babble making it through to take lead jammer status right after turn one for the Oli Rollers. Sassy now trying to stay out in front of Untamed Shrew.
Untamed Shrew makes it through, pushes out, gets to the inside, initial pass. 2-2 on the track. 3-2 now as Psycho Babble engages the pack.
4, because we now have J.K. Rowling out of the penalty box, as well as Mel Mangles, as Chikachula now headed to the penalty box.
That was a 3-0 on that one in favor of Oli, but Rose City are going to go with it into the next jam with probably the first blocker advantage they've had this entire period.
So now Ole, 111. Rose City, 72. 20 minutes, 08 seconds left on the penalty clock, or on the period clock in the second half.
J.K. Rowling jamming for the first time tonight. Great utility player for Rose City. You can put her in any position, and she will execute at it. Intentional fourth minor picked up by sulfuric acid. I saw an illegal procedure somewhere there. I think a false start. I didn't see who false started. It may result in a major.
Now we have Adam Matrix at the jammer line for Ole as Chica Chula is headed to the penalty box.
Rose City were waiting to get a 4-1 blocker advantage. Hockey Honey, though, one woman wall.
And here we have Adam Matrix playing through for Lee Jammer Status. As Hockey Honey headed to the penalty box, Lil Talkin now the only blocker on the track for Ole. Adam Matrix is now looking for a hole here. She's going to try to get around Frenchie. She's going to make her way around and call it up. Let's see if she picked up the point. Oh, she does.
Yeah, 4-4 in that one. Adam, before this jam, had 52 points on the slide. 54 points, Scald Eagle, 36 points. Sulfuric Acid, 23 points. I just changed it a little bit.
Fantastic maneuvering there at the end of that by the jammer for Rose City Rollers.
All right, so 3-1 blocker advantage for Rose City, Untamed Shrew jamming and Psycho Babble jamming.
Mercy taking a spill. Psycho Babble is going to take it on the outside lane to pick up lead jammer status. Joy Collision at the front. Joy Collision is going to be forced to allow Untamed Shrew to get through. Stella Baracha really is out on the track.
4-2 blocker advantage, and Psycho looks like going defensive jamming here to kill some time for Ole's blockers to get back out of the penalty box. Untamed Shrew fighting for it.
Wise moving. Untamed Shrew going to pull in front of her. Psycho Babble doesn't appear to be very concerned about that. Time's still running down. Psycho Babble going to put her hands to her hips.
We'll start Rose City with a 4-2 blocker advantage, which they have desperately needed. And what I need is Derby for All. Talk directly to thousands of Derby fans. Advertise on WFTDA.tv. Affordable packages are available for your business, boot camp, or tournament advertising. Visit WFTDA.com/sponsor/opportunities to learn more. You can also visit WFTDA.com/MVP to vote for your MVP, your favorite blocker, your favorite jammer. You can go out there. They will get good prizes from some of our sponsors. So support your favorite.
White Flight with an initial lead. Adam Matrix jamming for Ole. Adam Matrix is going to try to push her way around. Oh, amazing lateral movement to the right by Adam Matrix as she pulls through for lead jammer status. Sassy now just sitting on top of White Flight.
Havana Good Time going for the hit there. It did not work out for her as a swing and the miss gave Adam Matrix a huge score. Initial pass there. Speaking of initial passes, White Flight finally pushes out hers.
Adam Matrix moving around. She's looking to her bench.
Calls it off before White Flight can hit the back. 4-0 on that one for Ole. This second period not going well for Rose City. They have a hard time staying on the track. They rarely get lead jammer. When they do, it usually ends at a 0-0. Ole have been able to run away with it so far this second period, and we are just over a third, near halfway into it.
Rose City going to need to shift it up a little bit to regain that momentum that they had initially in the first half. On to Sly getting an assist from Psycho Babble right in the middle of the pack. That was genius. On to Sly picks up lead jammer status.
Major back block there for sulfuric acid. She'll go to the penalty box. This is going to be a power jam for Ole with a blocker advantage. Already 5 points there for Onda Sly. I predict a lot more for her as this goes. There's 5 more points. They had a out of play called for J.K. Rowland, so this is going to little Tonka there.
Scald Eagle now back in the pack to assist Heidi Go Seek and the Blast Unicorn.
3-3 in the pack, and Rose City, or sorry, Ole with some great offensive screens set up.
Oh.
Scald Eagle taking down on the slide, slowing her roll a little bit. She dances around the inside for another 5-point scoring pass.
It's going to increase the lead of Ole, 139, Rose City 76. And on a slide. Now going in, she's going to try to skirt around Scald Eagle on the Blast Unicorn. And then she looks like she's going to power through the middle. And Scald Eagle going to give the Blast Unicorn a little push there.
All right. That's Chikachula with a little bit of offensive help there. And Blast Unicororn now going to the penalty box. So it's a fourth minor there. So that's going to keep on the sly. At a pack advantage, power jam, another 5 points.
And Joy Collision Echo working in front of Sulfuric Acid, who's now back on the track. Psycho Babble recycling to the inside. That's 5 more points for On the Sly.
All right, we got all of the blockers in place for Oli. A 4-2, 4-1 blocker advantage as J.K. Rowling goes back to the penalty box. And Oli in a great position to effectively double the score. Close, not quite, but they're 3 points. What was a 2-point bout 15 minutes ago is now a 2-1 bout for Oli. Here we got On the Slide navigating through. Takes the hit there from Scald Eagle. They get him into position, but she gets out right after that.
If you want experienced derby skaters getting you the right gear to take you to the next level, check out derbyforall.com. That's derby, the number four, all.com. And remember, we do have this bracket bonanza going on, and the bracket bonanza sponsor is 2-in-1 Skate Shop. You can take 10% off your entire order at 2-in-1 Skate Shop with an E.com. When you see the coupon code Bonanza, use the coupon code Bonanza during checkout.
All right, slow start there. Try to get some Rose City skaters out there, I imagine. Untamed Shrew engaged in the pack, and
Adamatrix is the lead jammer for Oli. Sassy wearing the pivot helmet cover. Scared to Death now recycling to the front of the pack, as well as Chikachula. Nice little assist there by Scared to Death on Untamed Shrew, and now some positional blocking by Scared to Death as she, again, with an escort to the infield. Adamatrix makes it through on a scoring pass. She is going to pick up the full 5 points, put on the scoreboard for the Oli Rollers.
This is the 7th lead jam in a row for Oli Rollers, and Mercy just went to the penalty box for blocking out of bounds. Untamed Shrew finally makes her initial pass.
Chikachula, Lindsay, Lobo, and Scared to Death work the back of the pack for Oli.
And Adam gets around again. 4 more points, calls off the jam, pushes the lead to 158-76. Now more than doubling the score in just over half this second period. Well, I did mention Oli is really good in the second period. Now, according to our unofficial stats, though, Oli with 18 minutes in the penalty box, Rose with only 16, but they are doing it all at once, and when they do, Oli just pushes it. So even though it's relatively even on the penalty numbers, clearly Oli is capitalizing a lot more on them.
Psycho Babble skirts around Frenchie and picks up lead jammer status with a huge smile on her face as the crowd actually boos her going around. White what? Flight threw on her initial pass.
And I believe that is
Joy Collision.
Yes, Joy Collision go to the penalty box. She got that Arizona tan there, so don't recognize her.
Intended anchor. I caught that, Randy.
Oh, she was from Baltimore before. She was always a lot more pale. I'm like, who is that? Oh, that's Joy Collision. Block to the head for Joy Collision there, sending her to the penalty box there. This is going to be 3-2 blocker advantage for Oli.
Yes, it appears that it is. On to Slide now as the jammer. J.K. Rowling moving out to the outside lane. On to Slide going to try to blast through the Blast Unicorn. Oh!
Nice offensive maneuver from J.K. Rowling, giving Sulfuric Acid lead jammer. It is barely in reach for Rose City right now. They're going to have some really big jams to pull it out at this point. They can pray to the derby gods for some power jams that can get them in place. But quick scoring pass, 4 points there, and calls it off.
Time working in favor of Oli here, as On the Slide was already through on her initial pass. Sulfuric just didn't waste any time, calls off the jam. sends Onda Sly back to the bench.
And time is not on Rose City's side. 3-2 blocker advantage. Scared to death stepping up to the jammer line for Oli. Skull the Eagle for Rose City.
I see pack advantage in favor of Rose City. 3-on-2. Psycho Bubble Hockey Honey at the front. Scared to death looking for an opportunity. Well, with a nice defensive move by Scald Eagle as she takes Scared to Death to the infield.
As does Psycho Babble on Scald Eagle. Scared to Death trying to reach around the outside. And that is Scald Eagle out for lead jammer. And Rose City still at this point holding Scared to Death in the pack. Someone got something somewhere.
Frankenherder.
Frankenherder. And Frenchie.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, there you have it. Well, this says everything you need to know about the second period. 91 points for Oli, 21 points for Rose since the half.
Frankenherder now pulling up to the back of the pack. Hockey Honey, Psycho Bubble Joy Collision working the back. Havana, good time. Allows Scare to Death to pull around her as she did not want to incur a blocking out of play penalty.
That was her initial pass there. Going in for a little offense to hold off Hockey Honey and give Scald Eagle a scoring pass, which they do. She calls it off. Picks up how many? 4 more points there. 84 to 162.
If you want an opportunity to spend some quality time with, I don't know, Bonnie Thunders and OMG WTF, although it might be online or in store in the city that never sleeps, check out 5stride.com.
All right. Also check out S1 Helmets. They make the safest and best helmets in roller derby. S1 Helmets. So it's taking care of all our skaters right now. It makes me so emotional. So we have an official timeout right now. Looks like everyone's looking at the penalty board. So I'm guessing off the top of my head right now, it's going to be a penalty deliberation. But referees are taking their helmets off too. So, yeah, I think they're double checking. I don't think this is an official review, though. Spider.
We also want to remind you to stay tuned at 4 p.m. today. Angel City take on Rocky Mountain Roller Girls. Mm-hmm. As Rocky Mountain Roller Girls defeated Arizona Roller Derby earlier this morning. And then again, stay tuned 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Sacred takes on Rat City Roller Girls. They'll be duking it out for 5th and 6th, the winners of those two bouts.
And then a very exciting bout in at 8 tonight is going to be Bay Area. Adjusting the time clock there. Yeah, so technical difficulties with the clock. Got it all fixed, and we are on our way.
Oh.
Super easy inside pass there for Adam Matrix. She takes lead jammer.
Chikachula trying to lay a shoulder check there on sulfuric acid, but acid gets through on her initial pass. Adam Matrix now through on her scoring pass as she makes her way around JK Rowling. Heidi Goseek in the back here.
4-2 blocker revenge. Nice setup there. Getting a 4-point scoring pass from sulfuric acid and Adam Matrix running it.
Adam Matrix with 4 more points. We're going to have Intended Anger 911 headed to the penalty box for Oli. Sulfuric Acid going to try to make way around Chica Chula and Stella Baracha.
I kind of wonder if Adam Matrix is running the clock right now, and if so, that is a darn smart play. With this much of a lead and this much time, you pull those jams as long as they can go. That's just going to air you. You can match points for it, but it's going to be very difficult to Rose City to get the amount of jams they need to come back with that score if they keep pushing the amounts of scoring passes they do.
Right, and if you're confident you can continue to score and match the points and and disallow the opposing team to put any points on ahead of you.
Well, as much as Oli's been getting lead jammer, they can just keep getting lead jammer and do this in 4 jams. If they can get the next 4 lead jammers, run 2 minutes, it'll be nearly impossible for Rose City to bring this back.
White flight. Joy Collision with a nice assist as On the Slide picks up lead jammer status.
We'll see what they do with this. We do have a 4-3 blocker advantage for Rose City. On the slide, might hit it and quit it. Might push it. No, she's going to quit it. So apparently that isn't the overriding strategy.
Foiled again.
Hey, you know, you think you know something, and you throw it out there into the universe, see if it sticks. If not, whatever, you know. But still, nonetheless, time is on Oldie's side.
And always bring a towel.
All right, penalty trouble really not affecting anybody right now, according to our unofficial stats. Aside, Joy Collision, she's sitting on 5, but with 7 minutes left, probably won't affect her too much. Hanukkah Honey sitting on 4. Only Mel Mangle sitting on 3. Again, these are unofficial stats, so don't quote us on them.
We're on to slide, getting caught up at the back, and we have Scald Eel at the front.
Out of play called on Echo. Lead jammer, Scald Eagle.
There we go.
Not a moment too soon, but it might be too late.
Oh, on to Sly, just slips right through Kick Cassidy and Heidi Go Seek.
Outside screen, tried to set up a huge hit from Psycho Babble, pushing Scald Eagle to the outside. She doesn't go for it. She does pick up 3. She got the point from Psycho Babble and the 2 points from the penalty box, so even though she was hit out, she got most of her points right on that hit.
Oli now at 174, Rose City 95. 6 minutes, 16 seconds on the period clock.
80 points. It's about as done as it's going to be right now. You know, unless Oli decides all the jammers go to the penalty box right now, unless they make the life choice to send all their penalty jammers to the penalty box, this is Oli's bout. And they will be playing again tomorrow for the number one, number two seed.
Oh, once again, Rose City pulls through with sulfuric acid as lead jammer.
All right, and initial pass made by Adam Matrix. Scrappy, good luck. He's going to the penalty box, 3-3 in the pack.
Oh, nice move by sulfuric acid as she moves around a little Tonka on the right-hand side.
She got at least 3 of her points right now. Gets around Sassy, 4 points, and she's getting the signal to continue. At this point, it's more about trusting your blockers than trying to do the nickel and dime game because there's not enough nickels and dimes for this deficit.
And there goes Adamatrix on her scoring pass for 4 points.
All right, they're going to match points. Advantage Oli with 5 minutes and 10 seconds left.
Echo now being released from the penalty box as she makes her way back into pack play. Lil Tonka and Sassy work in front of the pack.
2 more points picked up by sulfuric acid there on that last run. 101, 178. Rose City breaking the century mark. 5 minutes left, 77 points to go. Yeah, it's pretty much all this.
Chipping away at that point differential. On to Sly. Scald Eagle. We're going to have all of Oli taking an E. We have 4 blockers on the track for Oli.
And it looks like only 2 there for Rose City.
JK rolling in the Blast Unicorn. On to Sly. He's going to pick up lead jammer status as Blast Unicorn tries to get out in front of her again, and On to Sly actually jumps around.
And it's a forearm major for Scald Eagle. That's it.
It's a power jam for On to Sly.
It is as done as it's going to get. Oli Rollers will move on to tomorrow's number one seed championship in the West Region Tournament bout. They're going to play the winner of Bay Area and Denver tonight. I know I'm calling it a little early, but it's a power jam and a huge score differential. So Rose City do have a chance to play whoever does not win tonight's bout for the third seed, which is going to be a huge bout as well.
Joy Collision headed back to the penalty box for the Oli Rollers. And we are Hockey Honey going to try to break up the wall there. Nice little hit by Scrappy Go Lucky on to Sly. Stella Baracha, Psycho Babble, Hockey Honey now going back to the penalty box. 3 minutes and 17 seconds left on the period clock.
Blocker advantage. On to Sly is going to call it off. She doesn't engage in that last one, but they will start the next jam with a power jam with a few seconds left there. What's called Evil. Less than 10.
And only pretty comfortable here, I think, there as they're sitting in Chica Chula. Chica Chula, a recent or more recent addition to the Oli Rollers here in the last season. And
Low Blow and Echo in the pack there. 4-2 blocker advantage for Rose City. 1-0 jammer advantage for Ole.
Not anymore. Here comes Scald Eagle right on the inside lane. Echo tries to recycle out in front of her. Scald Eagle pulls through for lead jammer status for Rose City Rollers.
Lead jammer right away. Okay, just needs 15 more 5-point scoring passes in 2.5 minutes for Rose City to take this bout back.
Lindsay Loblo.
We'll break about 10 different records, one in the inhumanly fastest person on skates.
Lindsay Loblo headed to the penalty box for the Ole Rollers. Scald Eagle through on another scoring pass for a grand slam for the City Rollers, bringing them to 111, only 188.
A cut major there for Chicachula, so this could be a power jam for Rose City.
Oh, it's a power jam. Chicachula, penalty box. Another grand slam for Scald Eagle.
Rose City slowing up the pack here. And Kick Akazidi going to the penalty box for some reason or other. Did not see the call.
Heidi Gosek and Frankenherter now two blockers. Hockey Honey has been released from the penalty box. Scald Eagle tries to juke around Echo.
That's another 5 points. They're going to bring it to 121 to 188. Jamis, 30 seconds left that period. She calls it off. We're going to start team timeout called by Rob Lobster. So you need two record-breaking jams right in a row to bring this back. But some stuff can happen, you know?
We want you to stay tuned. Next up at 4 o'clock will be Angel City and Rocky Mountain Roller Girls, followed at 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, Sacred versus Rat. And 8 p.m. Bay Area takes on the Denver Roller Dolls. Yeah, currently sitting Hockey Honey, Lil Tonka, and Psycho Babble standing on the track. 1 minute, 9 seconds left in on the second period clock. Again, Rose City 121, Ole 188. The winner of this bout then goes on to take either the first or second place.
I was checking our unofficial stats. I don't know that they're up to date. We have 23 minutes in the box for Rose City, 21 for Ole. I'd be surprised if that's actually where we're standing right now.
I would suspect it was higher.
Yeah, I think it's higher for both teams, and I think that Rose City probably has a few more minutes than two in the penalty box than Ole. Like I said, if you're matching penalty minutes with Ole, they're going to come out with the advantage due to their high level of execution. But I feel like Rose City's probably had more trips to the penalty box. Again, these are unofficial stats, so the only ones that are official are the ones written on paper. We have a official review, I believe, coming from Rose City there. They're going to review 40 of Ole's points, I'm guessing. See if they get 40 points back, maybe on the board, make this down to a two jam game. I don't know, we'll see how this goes. I'd be surprised if they got it.
It's likely that would be a no.
I'm pretty sure they're not gonna get it.
Some weird subversion of the rules. It's replay. Joy Collision taking a spill. Scald Eagle moves around. Echo, genius. Oh, we're going to send in a white flight. Chicachula still sitting in the penalty box. Psycho Babble, Hockey Honey, Lil Tonka working on the track. Mercy and Heidi Go Seek for Rose City Rollers. Lil Tonka knocks out White Flight. White Flight then recycles to the back of the pack. Hockey Honey now moving to the inside lane. Lil Tonka with a nice little hip check there at the end. Oh, Lindsay Loblo headed back to the penalty box. Again, Hockey Honey with an assist on White Flight to the infield.
That's Hockey Honey skills, man. She is the epicest of epic recyclers. She'll send any jammer to the back. Huge engagement there at the front. No call there. It was initiation into the Sturman, which is a legal target zone.
And Chicachula has now re-entered pack play, and she got through. Hop third pickup lead jammer status for the Ole Rollers with a minute and 3 seconds left on the jam clock.
Hit to the head by somebody. Hit to the head by somebody. I don't know what was going on with that.
We now, we have a hit to the head from White Flight. White Flight is now being...
Looks like a major, a gross misconduct expulsion. I don't know about that. I want to
see.
I'm sure there's going to be a review.
There will be a review.
All right. But that's at the end, so I don't know if the expulsion stands, but she has left. That is the end of the bout. Not the official score. Oli unofficially at 188. Rose City at 121. But I think we could definitely call this one for Oli. Oli just playing a high execution, incredibly physical bout. And they stayed on the track incredibly well. Really, really, really low penalties. And that's the game. If you can execute high and stay on the track, you are going to come out ahead. You are going to get the most points at the end, and that is exactly what Oli's done. Rose City's big opportunity coming into tomorrow's bout. Have to stay on the track. That has been a detriment to them here today. It really worked against them yesterday with Angel City really keeping it close. A lot of love coming for Rose City here from the crowd as they go out and take their lap as well.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Brad Example here for WFTDA.TV with number 50 of the Rose City Rollers, Scald Eagle.
Hi.
So this is your first weekend back to competition after a major injury. How does it feel out there on the track?
Amazing, in a word.
You were not victorious in this particular bout, but you now advance to face the losing team from Bay Area versus Denver. How do you prepare for that game?
We're just going to come into it as intense as we came into this game. That game is going to be a hard battle, as was exemplified by last night's bout between Rat City and Bay. So it's going to be as fun as this one. So I think it'll be closer. So
you seem to have the support of a lot of the crowd here in the arena today. Did that help you out on the track?
Absolutely. There's nothing like hearing the crowd go wild. Definitely helped my morale a lot. And our team did really well. I'm really stoked on how we did.
Congratulations on your performance. Good luck with the rest of the tournament, and welcome back to the track.
Thank you so much.